Hello, my dear children. This is the 9th module of Unit 3 Structured Query Language. In this module, we are going to deal with foreign key and its options. After foreign key is applied, we cannot delete any record or update primary key value in master table because its related records will be in foreign key table. There are two main options available while applying foreign keys. The first one is on-delete cascade. It means if any record from master table is deleted, its related records in the foreign key table will also be deleted. That means if you are deleting employee number 1, the entire record from the ABC Limited, in the training also the details regarding employee 1 will automatically be removed. Similarly, on update cascade, it means if primary key value in master table is changed, then it will be automatically reflected in the foreign key table. That means if you are changing the employee number 2 into 4, that is 2 you are making into 4, okay, the details of employee 2 in training table is automatically updated as employee number 4. The details of employee 2 will automatically converted into 4 by the compiler. That is the two options available for foreign key: on delete cascade and on update cascade. The next topic is column level versus table level constraints. Column level constraint is given with the column definition. Normally we will give with, consider a table called visitor. It is having a primary key as vid. Then you can create a table with the table level constraint. That is, table level constraints are given after all column definitions. That is vid in the primary key along with the, after all the columns you need to give primary key vid. That is the only difference between column level versus table level constraints. Then how to give the names for a constraint? As we discussed in the foreign key, you can give the constraint name by using a clause called a constraint and the name you wish to give to your constraint. Here the constraint I used is foreign key and references. So for this particular thing, for employee number, I am getting the foreign key with the name as my F key. So whenever I need to refer, I can give the name as my F key. The main usage of assigning name to a constraint is MySQL allows us to give names to constraint to that when error occurs due to constraint violation, then this name will appear to help us in identifying for which column this error occurred. Normally, if two columns having not null constraint and you are trying to give both the columns with the null values, at that time if you are getting an error, so you will be confused about which column got error. So if you are giving a name for not null, then it will be easy to rectify, or it will be easy to identify which columns not null giving error. Then as we discussed earlier, how to view the table structure by giving describe comment. We can give DESC or describe along with the table name and put a semicolon for entry of the tables. I think you're all clear about what is foreign key options. Thank you.